Alright. Spin. Alright, hey everybody, I'm Polo18 here. Welcome back to more Let's Play Pokemon Emerald! So, last time we met up at Meteor Falls and found out that Professor Cosmos was tricked into getting the meteorite for Team Magma. And, Team Aqua decided that they wanted to chase after him to Mount Chimney, which is where we are now. What? So, as you can see, we can't get down because they're blocking the way with their Puchenas. And there's just fights brawling out all over the place. You got Archie, I would assume, with his Mediana against all these Aqua guys. And these guys are fighting. And these guys are fighting. And so, it's just an all-out brawl. So, we got two Magma leaders here. Once again, Emerald's Classic. Try to get a double trainer going. So, where's the volume on this thing? I want to go ahead and bump it up a little. Yeah, I quick listened to the playback on that last episode. It was a little quiet on the music, so I'm going to go ahead and bump it up a little bit. Anyway, ooh, critical hit. Nice. Awesome sauce. Oh, yeah. Well, I already beat this trainer. I'll just have to do it from the menu. Ah, go faster. Okay. One thing I forgot to show... This move here, Air Cutter, I got rid of Peck, because Peck is only 30. Anyway, Hex with the Jellicoe has a high critical hit ratio, 5% missing accuracy, so, you know, not really too much. But, anyway, that Air Cutter is a really good move, so definitely with that. But like you see, if it came in here, you would have had to fight two of them. I just like fighting these trainers one at a time. I don't know what it is, you know, it's just something, like, I don't like having that experience getting split all over the place. You know, so this guy's got a Zubat. I'm going to go ahead and just Confusion, because I don't need a Psychic. That would just be a waste of power. And bam, gone. Get out of here, Zubat. Oh. Alright, so we defeated Team Magma Grunt. Grunting. Alright, so then up here we got another Magma Grunt. you're too late. We've already delivered the meteorite to Meteor Falls to the boss. Like a boss. So, this guy actually, oh, he's an admin. Okay, Magma Admin Tabitha, so I'm guessing he's probably a chick. She's got a Numel. Or Numel. So, one thing I thought was pretty cool, if you look at the spelling of Numel, if the U in Numel was an O, it's just the word lemon backwards. I thought that was so cool. When I first realized that, I was like, oh my god, look at it, it's lemon. So, actually, on one playthrough, I actually did name my Numel Lemon. And then when it evolved in the camera up, it was just useless to have it named Lemon. So I changed it to like Quake Fire or something, I don't remember. Anyway, Puchena can't really do much, but now we have Shockwave, yeah! Something against Dark-type Pokemon. So, that's always good. That's mainly the reason I taught it Shockwave, so I would have something against Dark-type Pokemon. And another Numel, let's go ahead and just bring out a Confusion. Confusion! Power! Ooh. Oh, yeah. So, this is still... I just decided to just go on an Emerald recording spree today. So, this is... Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the 5th video I've recorded today so far. So, oh god, not hiccups now. No hiccups! Anyway, this guy's just blabbering on about Team Aqua and how Magma's better and the land is all important and dedicated expansion of the landmass for the advancement of humankind and Pokemon. Anyway, so what they want to do is they want to awaken the sleepingness of the Mount Chimney. Pretty much this is the same dialogue as it was in Pokemon Ruby. So we have Leader Maxie. So I'm assuming maybe that's a chick. I can't imagine why a guy would be named Maxie. So anyway, so this Mediana out here has Intimidate. Not really a huge deal against Kumator because Special Attacker. So I'm going to go ahead and see how much Shockwave does. Ooh, not bad damage. Okay. Oh yeah, this guy's going to be caked then. So, yeah, I was kind of worried about the Mediana because it might have Crunch, but I don't think it's leveled up enough to have Crunch yet, so. Fight's okay. Anyway, yeah, this is kind of like it's kind of cool how Emerald kind of crosses over the two games, Sapphire and Ruby. And Ruby, this is the same as Ruby, where the Team Magma's up here trying to make the volcano explode to increase the landmass. And in Sapphire, it was Team Aqua, and they were trying to stop the volcano so that it would more water would be, you know, victorious or something. So anyway, not a hard leader. I mean, once again, overleveled, so not a huge deal. But that's just because I you know, I want to get this game going and get it, you know, get it done quick. So I mean, not that I really want to do any other games, but so anyway, so they're talking about some orbs. Ian, thank you for the help. We thwarted Team Magma's destructive plan, but you, whose side are you on? Ah, it doesn't matter. We'll remain vigilant and keep up our pursuit of Team Magma. We shall meet again. Indeed we will. Alright, so, cause effect wore off. So, what you can do is actually go ahead and here. Meteor is fitted into the mysterious machine. Do you want to remove the meteorite? Yes. So go ahead and grab the meteorite. And then it's going to go in our key items pocket. I think we can we check it out? I think so. Yeah. Meteorite found at Meteor Falls. So. And so this area is going to be completely empty. But what you can do is you can go ahead and go in here and come back out. Come back out! And then there will actually be, should be trainers in here. Well, I guess not. Okay, maybe that's later. But this lady here, lava cookies. So you can buy them for just 200. I'll go ahead and get one. So we get the lava cookie. And that's actually pretty cool because what lava cookies are, I gotta go all the way to the bottom. So Locust Master that heals all stats from, so pretty much it's a full heal. That's what it is. I mean, it's the same as this. So pretty much the same exact thing. Anyway, but now we're coming down here. Oh god, trainers. Let's see. Okay, I can get away from you. Alright, so see these rocks here? What's interesting about these rocks is I actually have the wrong bike, so I can't do it. But if you have the acro bike, you can actually hop on those rocks. You got to say. What are you doing here? Oh, I'm doing a place like this. Well, the business is sort of yours. Oh, okay, I can fight this guy? Oh, okay. I thought that wasn't until way later, but alright. Jeez. Okay, I guess I'll fight him now. This area is somewhat important later. In Emerald only, so. But I didn't think I could do this guy now. Alright, I guess I'll do. I'll go ahead and, you know, fight him, I guess. Pretty much you get a what's called a magma emblem or something. I don't remember what it's called. But anyway, what it does is it like lets, oh crap, I forgot his ground type. Yeah, look at the whole 5 damage. But it like it opens some kind of door in the side of the cliff where this guy is standing, so. Alright. And we won. Congratulations! Yeah, it ducked into your hideout, so. Anyway, it's right there. Oh, fuck this trainer. There's two trainers over there. Like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and beat up all these trainers off just because it's more convenient for me. I think I can get around that picnicker. So here's a Machop. There are pretty decent wild Pokemon around here, so. A lot of the Pokemon that you find in this area right here, it's called Jagged Pass. Probably showed it earlier, but a lot of the Pokemon. Ah, balls! Why? Why you gotta be turning like that, fool? Alright, I'm gonna cut this out quick. Alright, oh, okay, get more. Sure, I guess. Anyway, that guy had a Zigzagoon and a Tallow, so nothing too really difficult. So you come out here, there's this guy running. We'll just, you know, ignore him for now. Anyway, and then we get to Laveridge Town, so. You go ahead and, like, pretend you're taking a little sand bath. So go ahead and come in here. I'm gonna go ahead and heal up quick. It's pretty cool. Get my Pokemans healed up. Yeah, Pokemans. Alright. And then this kind of cool little thing, this little, it looks like a picture, but you can actually come back here. Talk to this guy, says we draw as much hot water as we need, and then excuse me. And yet the hot springs never run dry. Isn't it magical? The hot springs appear near active. Under the ground, heated by the magma up, well up hot springs. Alright, why don't you give it to me? Alright. Seriously, where is it? Alright, it better not be this old lady out front of the Pokemon. Is it you? Is it you? Nope. Okay. It's gotta be this old lady then. What the hell? Oh, here we go. Okay. Anyway, so this lady was hoping that her egg would hatch from the hot spring. Yeah, we'll go ahead and take care of the egg. Alright, so this is like the first, this is one of the first eggs you get in the game unless you like went ahead and like started breeding Pokemon. And you go to summary, it says egg obtained from the hot springs will hatch from this, so it'll take some time. So pretty much, it takes a while for these eggs to hatch. But it's not really too important. Pokemon Herb Shop, I'll check that out in a second. Let's see what's in here. Oh, okay. Yeah, I left two Pokemon and they discovered it. Okay, well, alright, so go ahead in this herb shop. Talk to this lady, herb shop. Inexpensive herbs. Now, so you got bitter powder, which is pretty much a super potion. This is a hyper potion, full heal. And then here we have revival herb. This actually works like max revive. I won't pick any up now, but later in the game I will actually come and pick them up. Since I don't have any Pokemon that evolve via happiness, I really don't need to worry about using revival herbs on them. Because what happens is when you use a revival herb, it actually lowers the happiness of your Pokemon. So I'm going to go ahead and sell that. Go ahead and sell that. Sell that. Sell that. White herb I want to keep. I think everything else is pretty good. Alright. Just wanted to sell some items, get some stuff out of my inventory. You know, I could go do the gym now if I wanted. Average gym, Flannery. You know what? I don't know really how long this is gonna take, so sorry if this is a shorter episode. But I'm gonna go ahead and stop, because I want to get the gym all in one stuff, and then we can definitely go and do some more post-game. I'm actually gonna run to Mog real quick and get the Acro Bike, go fight some trainers off camera, and then I'll be back right here. Oh, I didn't want to go in the gym. No, I didn't want to go in the gym. Spoilers! Ah! Anyway, I'll meet you guys right... Meet you rack... Oh, my God. Ah, commentary! Meet you guys right back here in front of the gym. Okay, see you guys next time. Bye-bye.